In one of his latest tweets, my friend Sturk said, "If you suffer from anxiety, try to swap out coffee with tea." Well, I did try that. I still don't like tea, but that is not the topic of this video. In this video, I actually wanted to talk about something that a lot of you have asked me in the past, and that is, how do I learn? How do I retain information? And with this, I want to show you how I basically retain and synthesize information that I get out of books or information that I get from online courses or doing online tutorials. Whatever kind of information I get, I usually don't go over it just once or follow along a course just once. I always take notes, and a lot of people in the community, and be it in the development community or in the hacking bug bounty community, said that over and over again how important is note taking. And that's what I want to show you today, because I think it's always worth it to see how different people do different things, and you can go ahead and you can cherry pick the stuff that works for you. That's at least what I used to do for the last couple of years. So I'm usually carrying a little notebook around with me that I have on myself all the time pretty much, and this is mainly because I don't really like taking notes in my phone. And because I'm into web development lately and I'm spending a lot of time doing web development, it's really handy to have something with you where you can quickly draw a wireframe or stuff like this. Or just take some quick notes, wrap up a quick to-do list or something like this. Just pen and paper, that's what I usually carry with me. The main thing I'm using, I'm going to show you in a second over on the computer. But what I do with this book, when I have this book, I'm not only putting this information in there once and then I forget about it in case I take like real learning notes, but I would go ahead and then later transfer those notes, and mostly while transferring them I shorten them as short as possible, and I would transfer it over to the tool I use for my note taking digitally. Talking about note taking tools, this video is unfortunately not sponsored by Notion, but this video is about Notion. Notion is the or is my number one note taking tool, and it took a lot of time for me to get used to it. I was using Evernote since I can remember, basically since it came out. I was only ever using Evernote, but since I got more involved with development and with bug bounties and hacking, I found it a little bit limiting in cases of creating hierarchies and stuff like this. You only could go two levels deep. Now I'm reading that they're actually trying to redesign Evernote to make it more versatile. I don't know what's that about, maybe I will check it out later again. But for the time being, I was switching over to Notion, I think about a quarter of a year ago or something like this. It took a lot of time, honestly, to first get used to it and second to transfer all my existing notes from Evernote over. There is an import feature in Notion that you can use, but it's still not formatted in a way that I would like. And I'm going to show you my Notion on the computer right now, and then we talk about how I take notes on learning. All right, welcome to my Notion. I don't want to turn this into a Notion tutorial. Nevertheless, I want to give you a very quick overview over what you can do with Notion. And with very quick, I really mean very quick, because I want to keep the focus of this video on learning notes and how to take notes for learning. Now, as I said, this is my Notion, and what you can do with that is you can create stuff similar like in Evernote. You can create different pages, and it's entirely up to you how you structure everything. Now, you can create a simple page that literally has some underpages in there as well. In this example, there's my notes on JavaScript, and there is a couple of underlying pages in there, and if you open a page, that's basically what you get. I like the minimalistic way of how everything is structured here, so there is nothing unnecessary in there. This is one way how you can use it. There's another way. I spent way more time on the hacking category that I created here than I spent on this, and you can see in a second why. If I click on this, I have all kinds of stuff right here on the front page of my hacking category. Now I can go through here, I can search stuff in here, and I can do whatever I want. There is even a board in there, like it's, how is it called?
I forgot the name. You know, those kind of boards that you use mostly for web development and process tracking, stuff like this. Trello is one app that uses those boards. And in fact, I also migrated my complete Trello over to Notion because it just works that way. And so you can display that here. You can display databases. You can display whole pages if you want to. But this is a more sophisticated way of displaying stuff. So if I go in there, then you just can pull up the page. I think this should suffice as a little introduction of Notion itself. And now let's dive into the actual learning notes that I take. All right, there we go. So what I usually do if I follow through a course is the following. You can see that here I have taken a note that everything in here needs to be revisited 48 and 72 hours later. At the 72 hour mark, I need to transfer the information to the appropriate categories, and I go into more detail for that now. What this is the 72 hour rule, I think it's called, and I got it from the book A Mind for Numbers, which is basically a book about learning and how to improve learning. And a big topic in there is revisiting content after a certain amount of time to really go ahead and synthesize the information that you have read before. Now the notes in here will be now mostly about web development because this is where I put the most of my attention to at this moment, but also UI and UX design. I really like this approach because what I do is, and you can see those timers are red and I kind of missed that because I was too busy to actually do my duties here. But what I do is, every day I'm learning, I create a new date here as a H1. And I really like that Notion supports Markdown, so I can go ahead and create notes really quick and really fluent, and I'll show you that in a second as well. So I create a date for the day that I'm sitting down and learning or getting some new information in. What I do next is I create two timers, or two reminders actually. One reminder will be in 48 hours later, so I click on that, and I would choose 2 days from the moment I am learning. Or I'm putting the initial notes in. And then I create another reminder that would be 72 hours later. And both of those would pop up on my phone and remind me that I need to get my stuff done. The first thing I do, which is the 48 hour mark. Once that 48 hour mark is hit and I open up my Notion, usually in the morning, first thing, I'm going to simply read through all of this information or all of the notes I have taken one single time, or sometimes twice. I try to ingrain it into my brain as much as I can. If there are certain topics that I maybe don't fully understand yet, I might even go a little bit deeper and try to understand the topic once again and try to understand the information that I have put down in my list. Once more and try to get a deeper understanding of that, but I don't spend too much time on it. Now, you can see there are a couple of different notes here, so I would go through all of that. And as you can see here, there is already the next day, which is due today for reading. Then when the 72 hour mark hits, the next rule applies, which is I need to transfer the information to the appropriate categories. Now, one more thing I do at the 48 hour mark is I try to narrow the content down as much as possible. This is a bad example right here because there is no actual written notes. That's just a bunch of code that I pasted in here. But let's go down a little bit more. Here's something on UI UX design that I have learned on the 19th. And what I would do actually as of today, because I'm still due to read that, I still didn't do that. So we can go through it basically right now. I would just read through those bullet points once again, and I would see duplicate pages in prototype view to keep linking and navigation intact. Now I would try to shorten this even more. Now this is already pretty short, so it's really hard. So I would do duplicate pages in prototype view to keep it. That's actually not even possible to short that anymore. Next one, create a navbar holder where all the links, there we go, where all links are set up, and just copy the navbar two new pages within prototype mode. Okay, I shortened it a little bit. Next one, example, copy navbar, select all pages holding shift paste, already short as well. Now what I found that this particular thing does is, it forces me to really reread the sentence and not just fly over it. Because if I need to think about how I can potentially shorten the sentence even more, so that I basically only have bullet points that remind me of the stuff that I should already have ingrained into my brain, that really helps me to make those connections in my brain, in the brain cells, or whatever you want to call it, in the neurons, that you really fortify those connections, and it really, really helps me to do that. So I would always do that. And once the 72-hour mark is actually hit, then I would do the same thing one more time. So I would read through it once, and then I would go ahead and try to shorten it even more. And once that is done, I'll go ahead and copy all the content that is right here into the appropriate categories where I want to store the information for later access. Now we can do that right now because I have a couple of things here that I need to transfer over. Actually, already I should have transferred that yesterday. There is a piece on a React and styled components. So I would just simply go ahead and copy this styled components thing here, and I would just cut it out actually. And I would go to my development section. I would go to React, and then I would see if there is already a appropriate category existing. Let's see what we have here. We have React, create new React app, basic React component. Not really. So I would go ahead and would create a new page called styled components, and I would just paste my information right here. Now we can turn this into a H1 as well, because this is kind of the topic that is the most prevalent here. And then we go back to the actual learning page, and I would repeat that with the next component, or with the next thing that I want to save, which is functional components. And I would cut that out as well, go back to development and go back to React. And then let's see, what is that? Basic React component, functional component. It's basically already here, but this information is a bit more dated than the one that I just pasted right now. So I would just paste that on the top there. And I would also go ahead and change this into an H1. All right, and then if I go back to the actual notes, I would just go ahead and basically mark this as complete, which I do by just simply deleting it. And this also needs to go out. And then we are due with the next day. So you can basically see what, how my workflow looks like. And I found it really helpful to also use Markdown, and I want to show you an example. There's a lot of information there already. If I need to create, example, a new day, that's already existing now for today, but I just want to give you a short example on how easy it is to just create a new day. You just go ahead and copy this. You put it down. You paste it, and let's say this is tomorrow, and I know already that I will learn something new tomorrow, so I will just do that right now. And the first thing I do is I go into the reminder, and I will move that to what is tomorrow, first day, so I will move that to Saturday, and the next one I will move one day ahead to Sunday, so I have that completely set up. As I said, one reason why I really love Notion is that it supports Markdown, and I haven't used Markdown before, but now I'm completely addicted to it and I basically cannot live without it anymore. The reason being, I will show you that in a second to understand that a little bit better. But the first thing I usually do is I do a H1/H1, gives you directly an H1, which you can directly go ahead and type in. Now I do, let's say I'm doing a Andrew Meet JavaScript course. So this is just simply that I know what this topic is about, or what have I done on this particular day. And this is always an H1 for me. And then the subcategory is an H2 always. So the H2 would be in this case, let's say JavaScript arrow functions. And then I would go ahead, arrow functions look like this. always when you hit enter, the next is a paragraph, so this is cool. And then you can go ahead, use Markdown to create a code snippet right there, and you can go ahead and do const arrow function equals whatever. We got the arrow function right here, then we put that in there, and print or whatever alert XSS, and this would be my note. And you can see how quickly you can put those notes together just simply using Markdown. Now the reason why I use this formatting, the strict formatting, even in my notes, is exactly because what I have showed you before, that I can go ahead and just grab this and cut it once again. Let's do that. And now I show you an example why I do that. So I go back to JavaScript. Now I need to find something that actually has kind of a lot of different stuff in there. So let's go to, probably loops will have something. No, it doesn't. DOM has something, I know that. You can see that I created a table of content for most of the pages where there's more than 3 or 4 different things in there. So I can quickly navigate to the stuff where I want to go. Now, I use this H2 because if there is like a subcategory of functions or whatever, I can just go ahead and paste it there and it will automatically be reflected here inside of this table of contents. And what I mostly need to do is to change this back into H1, but that's not a big problem for me. And then it automatically gets reflected here in the table of contents. Now we can also go ahead and do this inside of the learning notes, basically. Let's put that back in here and I'll just show you how to create a table of contents. Now this is an H1, let's put it into an H2. And usually I have a table of contents here on top actually. And this is really easy to do. So you do forward slash, you type table of contents and boom. You have your whole table of contents in here. So you see exactly what kind of days you have still open and what kind of topics you have still open. And this basically helps me to easily transfer the information over to the appropriate pages once the 72-hour mark is hit.
So guys, this is basically it. This is how I kind of synthesize information and stuff that I learn. I always religiously take notes on almost everything. If I go through a video course, I stop the video so many times just to write down some stuff that I want to retain, that I found to be important. And I do the same with books. I can do a separate video on books if you like, how I kind of process information in books. I take a lot of notes inside of the actual book, and later I would go ahead and I would transfer this information in the same fashion that I have just shown you in Notion. I would just transfer it over to a particular learning day in Notion. Then I would narrow it down and shorten it as much as I can before transferring it to the appropriate category in my Notion database. Now, if you like this video, guys, you know what to do. I hope it was helpful to you. If it was, give it a thumbs up. Also, please subscribe to the channel. I promise I'll create more content in the near future. I have a big change coming up very soon. I'm working on a rebrand, kind of, and I want to put out more content. I very soon have much more time for content creation because I'm actually in the process of doing a career shift more towards being a content creator and a developer and a hacker. And I hope you are excited for that, same as I am. And I hope to see you back in the next video. If you have any suggestions of what you want to learn, what you want to get out of the next video, leave a comment below. I would be very happy about that. And I hope to see you back in the next one, guys. Until then, have a good one. Bye.